VR hardware can be pretty finicky. So in this video, I'll be teaching you ways to fix all of your VR hardware and software problems as best as I can. And no, it isn't, oh, have you turned it off and back on again? Because of course you have. Anyways, this is Vive's flagship PC VR headset, the Vive Pro 2. A 5K resolution, massive field of view, and a really pretty price tag. For $800, you would hope that it would just work.
I'm not kidding.
It's never that simple. For the three people that bought them, the Pro 2 is incredible, and I've loved using mine for the past 2 years despite my brutality. But with no explanation, mine is dead, like Horizon Worlds levels of dead. And after a month of troubleshooting with Vive support and them sending me an entirely new headset, it still wasn't working. Spoiler alert, I got it to work by learning more about VR than I ever wanted to know before and doing what Vive calls the impossible. Let's get into it. First, let's talk about the symptoms. The Pro 2 was giving me all sorts of weird errors, from being straight up undetected all the way to thinking it was the wrong headset entirely. When I could get it to work, the headset would be full of what we would call in the wasted money industry, grayouts. This means that for whatever reason, the headset doesn't know where it's at, and this can lead to some craziness, like your head flying across the world. So to save you from motion sickness, your headset essentially pulls the wool over your eyes until it knows where it's at again. So why does a VR headset lose tracking? Let's start with the simple stuff. 99% of PC VR gear uses base stations to track. Source? I made it up. These little guys emit light by spinning lasers incredibly fast, over 60 revolutions per second, and your headset will pick up this light by means of these little dots, or sensors. All of that spinning can really wear these guys out. In just under 300 hours of playtime, these things do a total of over 1 million revolutions. To see if your base stations are the problem, grab your phone and turn on the camera to check that these two little guys are here. If one of these dots are missing, it means that that base station has a mechanical fault and needs to be fixed or replaced. Mine look exactly as they should, but while we're here, if you only have one base station, make sure that it says A mode here, or if you have 2.0s, make sure it says A mode in SteamVR. Now if you have two, make sure one of your base stations is set to B, and all of the other ones set to C. Side note, 3.0 trackers are compatible with 1.0 base stations. I don't know why, but this is a really common misconception. Then again, the whole base station thing is hard to understand. Anyway, if your base stations look like this and aren't making any insane noises, they're good, and it's time to check something else, like, reflections.
Since it's all light-based, a poorly placed reflective surface like a TV, window, or even a nice shiny bald head can interfere with your tracking. I'm not kidding, your expensive VR rig can be killed by Mr. Clean's shiny dome. My PlaySpace has the worst reflection. Got a TV, got windows, got LED bulbs. At least I'm not bald. But when I plug in the original Vive, it tracks perfectly fine. In my experience, reflections are rarely the issue, but it's worth a shot to turn off some lights or cover up screens.
One of the more common issues that can result in lost tracking is overheating. The sensors that track you in VR are very susceptible to heat, and luckily Vive made the awesome choice of making an $800 headset that can overheat to the point that it actually delaminates its own screens. Oh boy, do I love corporations.
For an Index, you can get one of these made to fit fans, but for the Pro 2, I had to get my engineering hat on. I love you, Noctua, please sponsor me.
After all that, the next usual suspect is your headset's cable. These things twist and bend all sorts of directions, and that can lead to broken connections in these sensitive little cables.
The original Vive uses an archaic 3-in-1 cable, a bog-standard HDMI, a USB, and a power connection straight into the headset. Nowadays, headsets like the Index and the Vive Pro series use cables that aren't so consumer-friendly, terminating in this weird plug called Oculink.
And no, weirdly, it doesn't have anything to do with Oculus.
Symptoms of a bad cable includes sparkly pixels, various screen artifacts, and tracking loss like my situation.
On the older Vive, you could replace any of these connections with any old HDMI or USB cable, but unfortunately with these new ones, you simply can't do that. So to check your cable and see if it needs replacing entirely, here's some valuable tricks.
Lay out your cable and take note of any nasty bends. Plug in your headset like you normally would and run your hand down the cable on those bends. Feel free to loop it like this to see if it fixes the problem. If it fixes it, you've got a break. I've seen a few people run cable ties and loop the cable on the broken spot to get them by until their new expensive proprietary cable arrives.
So I replaced my cable, plugged it in, it all worked. Turn everything off and back on again, and now I'm having the same problem as before.
This is where it gets interesting and honestly a bit headache inducing.
Welcome to hell, aka software troubleshooting. If you made it this far, I'm sorry.
This is a USB, and hopefully by this point you know what this is. Your headset and computer use it to talk to each other, so if there's any issues, you're in for a bad time. While USB has been around since 1996, it seems like manufacturers are still having a hard time getting it to work properly. If you use AMD, this is likely going to fix all of your issues. This has also worked for some Intel users, although I don't personally own any Intel products. First, go into your BIOS. I need you to disable C-State Power Management. C-State Power Management is a power-saving feature that allows your computer to shut USB devices off at random, including your VR headset. So make sure that that's off. Now, I want you to undo any cool gamer overclocks that you've done to your CPU or RAM. No overclocky boys. And the most important thing, I need you to change your PCIe X16 to Gen 3 speeds rather than Gen 4 or 5. I don't know why. Just do it. Remember that computers are just rocks that we tricked into thinking by shoving lightning inside. It never made sense to begin with. With that, I'm sure 99% of you will have your problem solved. This has all worked for me in the past, but unfortunately not this time around. L plus ratio plus bozo. And now here's the juicy stuff. Stuff that Vive certainly told me wasn't possible. And if there aren't any real hardware issues, this will get you up and running. But I need you to stick with me for the process. It's gonna get a little bit dense. To avoid any conflicts while we're troubleshooting, I need you to unplug everything besides your RGB mouse, clicky gamer keyboard, and your gross sweaty headset. Please clean it. Launch SteamVR, go into the developer settings, and click uninstall all USB drivers, and after it's done, unplug your headset. Hit your PC with a quick restart, and wait for it to boot back up. After it boots back up, I need you to plug your headset right back in. You should hear something similar to this, and that means that your headset is now installing fresh drivers onto your PC. While you're here, you might as well uninstall SteamVR and do a fresh reinstall. And if you're like me and are forced to use Vive console, it'd be a good idea to reinstall that too. All of this just makes sure that there's no software conflicts in your system. Next, go into your Windows search bar down below and type memory integrity. This is something that I didn't even know existed, but upon closer inspection, it can actually cause conflicts with drivers. It's pretty goofy, I know, but we're trying to cover all of our bases here to make sure that your shit works. And now the single most important piece of information that I needed to get my stuff back up and running. I got a Quest 2 while my Pro 2 was down. Now, of course, I wanted to use it with my Index controllers and the full body that I already have, and the cleanest way to do this is to use something called a tracking override to essentially make the Quest 2 base station track. I'll have a video out in the future about that, but if you need help, join my Discord down below and I'll help you set that up. It was pretty easy getting that working, so I was curious if maybe it was possible to bypass the tracking on my Pro 2 the exact same way. And after asking Vive if it could work, they kindly told me to go fuck myself. This will work on any headset. What we are doing is essentially telling Steam to ignore whatever the headset is saying and use something else in its place, whether it's a controller or a tracker. So I got my hands dirty in the config files. Well, not really. It won't take you long. Follow the directory path on screen. Don't worry, I'm gonna leave it up there for a while, and open default.vrsettings with Notepad. There's only two things in here that I need you to change. That would be set require HMD to false and enable multiple drivers to true. Save that and get the hell out of Dodge. And yeah, that's it. You developer now. Yay! Basically, what these two settings do is require a headset for SteamVR to load fully, and this one allows multiple drivers to communicate with SteamVR. At least that's what I think it does. Now, at the top of this file, you'll find some nicely worded notes from Valve. Unfortunately, with every SteamVR update, these will all be changed back to default. So if you don't want to do this again, copy that file that you edited and mark it as a backup. When SteamVR updates, delete the backup in the name and replace the old one. Join the Discord down below if this somehow didn't fix your problem, and members of my community and I will help. Just don't ask Slimpy. Huge shout out to my Patreons for supporting the channel. Without them, there's no way that I would have been able to find this stuff out. And as always, have a good day, amigos.